наша с вами сегодня сессия,
our today's
она
session
смещает,
combines two main
взгляд,
questions
два,
of the modern
economy. Из основных вопросов в современной экономике. Но это, конечно,
the issue of the last decade is digitalization,
цифровизация, да, наладка цифровых процессов, переход на
digital
новый
processes adjustment
технологий. И,
and
взгляд, опять
the transfer to the new level of technology usage. And the major problem of the 21st century is the climate problem. The problem is getting more and more serious. We have figures that in the regions with extreme heats, more lives were taken than COVID. Than by COVID.
Особенно в более южных странах бизнесы, которые раньше были
and businesses that existed in some countries, especially in southern countries, they had to close down or to be restructured. I'm sure that many of you know that right now there is a conference in Egypt, COP27, and these problems are being discussed there. A few days ago, there was a day when world leaders presented their ideas and they underlined the importance of the climate agenda. Today we're going to discuss how we can combine two agendas, digitalization and climate issues.
И здесь, ну, как, наверное, во всех
and here, as well as in many other business
questions,
we can look at the problem from different sides.
Голосование, да? Я могу, или я
can
могу
I
включить, ну, давайте сейчас я два слова
switch
скажу,
on first, or do we need to start from voting? We can look at the problem from different sides.
Ну, во-первых, конечно,
firstly,
we
should look at digitalization, how it can help us in solving
combating
in solving questions related to combating global warming. Another topic is how digital businesses and digital processes influence climate.
Потому что здесь мы знаем,
we know that the influence can be quite significant. And in terms of climate, there can be not actually positive digital processes. For example, cryptocurrency. They draw serious attention on how to reduce the influence, the negative influence of, on cryptocurrency, on climate.
Пожалуйста,
so let's
голосование.
Start voting. Dear colleagues, I
Коллеги,
hope you've registered in the system. We have three
системе.
Simple questions for voting. The first question. If digitalization helps to combat climate change, the first answer, no, it increases it, yes, it helps a lot, and the third answer, I'm not sure if there is anyone who would choose this answer, since you came here. So the third answer is that combating climate change is irrelevant now. So please vote.
Пожалуйста, просьба голосовать.
And could you please start my presentation? I'll show some slides.
Презентацию. Несколько слайдов я покажу. В качестве введения, пока идет голосование. Так,
could you switch to the next slide, please?
У меня кликер работал. Можно следующий слайд?
Just a few more words about our agenda.
Несколько слов на предмет нашей повестки. Да, сейчас идет
there is a conference, COP27, as I mentioned. The preparation to this conference was not so well
потому что в этом году достаточно много
announced as a year before, since we have a lot of new problems in the world and in Russia, the access to foreign markets and foreign technologies has reduced. Still, in the Bank of Russia, we think we cannot stop with the green agenda. We need to continue with it due to several reasons. The first reason is that the climate issue has not disappeared, especially its influence on Russia. And the influence of climate change is significant all over the world, especially in Russia, in the northern part, and we need to look at this problem. Another side is our new trade partners, some of them,
они, в принципе,
are influenced by the climate agenda. Maybe they not actually see themselves as active players to combat global warming, but they definitely feel victims of climate change processes. And they have agendas and specific programs related to issues, how to solve the issues occurred from climate change. And from financial point of view, we will need to deal with these issues and work on financial direction. We have to adapt and manage risks of the financial system related to the climate agenda. And at the same time, we need to create new tools for economy and financial system to reduce the risks. And this is what we are currently doing. The next slide.
И для финансовой системы по снижению этих рисков, чем мы и занимаемся. Так, следующий слайд.
So how digitalization can help in climate projects? I'm sure that our colleagues today will tell us more about that. First of all, everything that is related to measuring, analyzing of the influence on climate and ecology, and also how these processes can be improved and optimized, how we can reduce carbon footprint and its influence on the environment by forming new markets and former markets. I have told already that there is an influence itself on economy that occurs by digitalization. But we can also mention greenwashing, for example, Dieselgate, famous Volkswagen case. The next slide, please. And there is a wide range of companies.
Широкий круг компаний, который сейчас занимается тем, что именно предлагает цифровые решения для измерения или
to measure the effects on climate and to improve the processes.
На климат для совершенствования процессов.
Let me introduce our speakers. Today we have very interesting speakers. You cannot see them all right now. I'll start with Татьяна Завьялова, Senior Vice President of ESG Sberbank. Here we have the representative from Kazakhstan, Aydar Kazibayev, CEO of AIFC Green Finance Center, Chairman of the National ESG Club, Alexey Miroshnichenko, First Deputy Chairman of BEB, RU, Maxim Rimchukov, Director of Sustainable Development of Sibur Holding. The next question I'd like to ask Alexey Miroshnichenko. A lot has been said at the beginning. Mrs. Zhang said about accounting, about climate accounting, and also estimations of projects, green credits. Here we create similar structures in Russia. We have recommendations, and we create the market of green projects, and a very important role BEB plays in these projects, not only as a player, as a market player, but also as a creator of infrastructure. Could you tell us more about that, about your role?
Существует уже, можно сказать, год с небольшим. Да, за это время у нас
When we talk about the age of technology and finances, climate and green, market as a financial tool exists for a long time in the world. And in Russia it exists over a year.
Наверное, можно уже перекидывать мостик и финтех.
We have verified 10 tools for 384 rubles. 384,000 rubles. Mrs. Zhang announced much bigger amounts.
Финтех может с одной стороны этим инвесторам
дать. So the figures are much bigger. However, Chinese economy is much bigger as well.
Рейтингование, присвоение
статуса. For a year and for a little bit over a year is also significant.
Экспертным аппаратом, как коммерческий банк, для проверки, анализа,
расчета. We have verified 10 tools for 384 billion rubles. And yes, Mrs. Zhang announced much bigger amounts a Chinese economy operates with. But we know that Chinese economy is much bigger than Russian, so we see our results as significant as well.
Статус зеленой облигации или адаптационной. Да, он такой трехзначный. Там она либо зеленая, либо адаптационная, либо ни та, ни другая. Сейчас
on the market we have five bonds.
Эта информация, она
issued bonds.
Собрана, она находится на нашем сайте.
Total volume is 255 billion rubles.
Да, то есть ее можно прочитать глазами, но пока еще никто,
bonds
ни один issued брокер,
of which are rated at the level of the sovereign. And here we can bridge to fintech.
Платформа не пришла, не спросила, ребята.
What do we want to see on the market today?
То что на самом деле, что
we want to see individual investors.
Можно окружать статусы, последнюю верификацию, то что они прошли очередную ежегодную сдачу документов.
Can give investors a bridge and comfortable ways of investing and at the same time our tools of crediting and giving the status to bonds.
Огромное количество. То есть вот мы, например, знаем, что все проекты, которые сэкономят после запуска, 10,6 миллионов долларов в год. То есть примерно 1% от всей российской экономики.
Scoring,
да, вот мы эту информацию уже готовы обгружать.
To give this investor the starting point, whether it is green or not, sustainable or not.
Скажет «дай».
So here we have two tools that work well. This is the status of green bond.
Вторая история, которая у нас есть, которая, опять же, может быть полезна и интересна
индивидуальному инвестору,
которую, опять же, тоже готовы отгружать, это другая наша система рейтингования.
This bond can be either green or adaptational or neither.
IRIS. Проект устойчивые инфраструктурные проекты. Опять же, да, тема инфраструктурных проектов, она большая, в ней индивидуальных
инвесторов. This information has been collected. You can find it on our website. But right now it's not fintech. You can read it by your eyes, but no broker, no trader.
Инженеров надзорных компаний для того, чтобы проект проанализировать, сказать, да, он хорошо,
no platform has come to us and asked to give them description.
Методологию которого тоже разработал веб.
We can deliver papers. We can deliver statuses, the last verifications.
Он как раз отвечает и на вопрос.
The fact that they submitted annual documentation.
То есть не пострадали ли интересы граждан.
How many tons of CO2 they saved?
И наконец, что у него с финансами, что у него с управлением, с
прозрачностью. How many tons of CO2 was saved per rubble of investment? We have all this information. We have really deep reports on verification.
И дать возможность поинвестировать в дороги, мосты.
We know that all projects that have been verified, they will save
10.6
million
tons
of CO2 per year.
Напишем, дадим.
This is approximately 1% of emissions from the whole Russian economy.
Следующий вопрос к Татьяне Завьяловой.
We are ready to provide this information. Any broker or trader that comes and asks us to give, we can immediately write and provide this information. Another thing that we can have that can be really helpful to an investor, and this information is ready to be provided. This is our scheme of the project ratings.
большое за вопрос.
This is about projects, not about bonds.
На него ответить, я бы предложила, наверное, начать.
The system is IRIS, sustainable infrastructure projects.
Перейти к частному. Ну, во-первых, мы говорим зеленый.
The topic of infrastructure projects is really huge. We haven't noticed any share investors there.
Ну, в нашем понимании,
there are various reasons. A bank needs really a pool of specific experts.
В мире, по которым финтех в мире сейчас развивается.
Я legal advisors,
цифр. Да, и финтех,
companies who would make monitoring
темпами.
And control
в прошлом году по
to analyze the project and to understand whether it is sustainable, whether the money will be returned.
210 миллиардов долларов, что больше, чем в два раза больше
the rating,
за тавтологию, чем в 2020 году. А что
which methodology
там
was
с зеленым финтехом, если
performed
вы
by web? And it is being launching by the
IRIS
project. Within the IRIS project, that answers the question: what's with ecology? What about the social factor? Whether the citizens will not suffer who live near this project? What about the management? What about the transparency?
Направлении зеленого финтеха, но при этом объем инвестиций.
And this rating can be a starting point for estimation for an individual investor.
22-го тоже вырос прямо огромным.
When some crowdfunding platforms can provide access
40 миллиардов
and invest into bridges, roads and huge factories. So the same situation as with green project. We collected all information, we publish it on our website, and the first company who comes and asks us to provide this information, we will give it. Thank you very much. The next question is to Татьяна Завьялова. Sber, as we know, is the most greenish, the most green, the most digital bank. I know that you develop green agenda very actively. Could you please tell us if you tried to combine two agendas, the green one and digital one? Thank you very much for the question. I'll try to answer it. I'll suggest to start from general to specific. When we talk about green fintech, what's the difference between fintech and general? As we understand, there is no difference. This is one of 20 directions. Fintech is developing in the world. I can tell you several figures. Fintech is growing very fast. Last year, according to the estimation, Fintech was invested $210 billion. That is much more than in 2010. And what is about green fintech, if we look at the share? It's really interesting. We talk about green fintech. And we don't know whether investors support it, whether any investors go there. And if we talk about fintech representatives, according to international data, only not more than 8% work in green fintech. At the same time, the volume of investments into green fintech in 2021 compared to 2020 has grown significantly,
понятно, что это большие
and it accounted for $40 billion.
Технологии. Для чего мы
That's
это
really
делаем?
Good indicator
того,
of growth.
В перспективе
the growth was around 100% from year to year. It means that green fintech exists
профилем.
And is developing
Сейчас
very actively. So
такими
I think we understand the terminology.
Тоже,
what do we do? We've divided fintech into three directions. As we are green in all meanings and we are digital, we approach to it like a factory of products. And this product should solve specific tasks. And we've divided these tasks into three directions. The first group, these are our retail clients, how to work on green agenda with them.
Калькулятор этот дорабатываем для того, чтобы
we started
он оценил
over a year
большее
ago,
количество параметров и факторов.
And the second
вот
year we estimate our clients according
того,
to their behavior about their way, how they use their credit cards, how they purchase
части.
Services and make payments.
Но здесь все с одной стороны
and we have a category
проще,
of G clients, green clients.
Сложнее. Мы сейчас
we have quite wide range of parameters, over 30 parameters.
продукты,
we can estimate
в нашем корпоративном our clients, they also are divided into groups, ecology, social aspects, and educational, and healthcare. Кредитный процесс, соответственно, все системы,
in 2022, the number of clients increased
для наших стандартных банковских услуг
by 50%.
И для зеленого направления. Now we have 14.7 million people. This is quite a good number. Тем не менее, все не так просто, потому
this is the first step, our first product in green fintech. Of course, this is big data, modern technologies. Why do we do so?
А вот с этим как раз we do to be able to как вы знаете,
produce
в России
products with green or social profile.
150,000, раскрывает не более 150 тысяч компаний.
Now we are working on such products.
Это, ну,
the next
немного.
Thing,
вот
when we talk about specific clients, retail clients,
мы здесь имеем,
we've developed and had a pilot version of a calculator, carbon calculator, that can measure individual CO2 footprint.
Что, конечно, затрудняет автоматизацию процесса, что мы здесь делаем. Здесь мы совместно с блоком риски и совместно с нашим корпоративным блоком разрабатываем
GVT-ину
клиентов.
Сейчас
там уже более нескольких миллионов клиентов.
So that it can measure more parameters and factors. So this is another example of how we work with our clients. In retail, what about our corporate clients? On the one hand, it is simpler, but on the other hand, it is quite complicated.
Our
ESG products were built in the corporate direction, in our standard credit process. So all systems of automatization that are used for our standard bank services work for green direction as well. Moreover, we can say that nothing is simple here. Big data in fintech is what works with, like fintech works with big data, and it's not easy to do so, as you know.
Технологическая компания и у нас достаточно.
As you know, in Russia, only around 150,000 companies show their financial reports, and this is not a lot. We have over 3 million clients, corporate clients, and we have confirmed information only from 150,000 clients. And this information can be shown in different formats, which makes it even more complicated to automate the processes. What can be done here? Together with blocks, risks, and our corporate blocks, we develop ESG window for clients. We have over several millions of clients, and we describe them according to 200 parameters in this window, how we can describe our clients, and this is a huge work. As a result, there will be a possibility to automate the processes using ESG information in the full range and work with ESG direction using green fintech. This is what I wanted to say about our corporate clients. And we also heard the thesis about digital technologies who can influence the environment differently. We have concerns about that as well. And our direction in AI, and I just forgot to mention that we feel that we are a tech company. We have a lot of resources, people and technical resources that are involved into this direction, and we pay attention to carbon footprint.
Который мы здесь
разрабатываем, live that work with AI that create models.
Спасибо большое, Татьяна. In this direction. Интересно, вы у меня сорвались с языка. Я вот вас как раз хотел спросить.
Our colleagues together with Moscow Institute of AI created the following. Let me check the information. So they developed an open library that is called Equal Tool AI, who allows to calculate
что усиливают проблему изменения цивилизации 70%, что может существенно помогать, и 10% что вообще нужно забыть про эту повестку. Вот у меня вопрос, Максим, во-первых, с мнением аудитории,
of deep learning. This is an open tool. We placed it during summer, and we have over 7,500 downloads of this library. And according to our experience,
компания.
When the solutions from this library are applied, it led to reduce emissions when they use AI software. They reduced by 10-15%. So this is one more product that we develop here that is related to energy saving. Thank you very much, Татьяна. That was very interesting. I just wanted to ask you whether you do anything related to modernization of your own processes. I don't see the results of voting, unfortunately, but I will remind you that 20% of our audience think that digitalization increases the problem of the climate change, 70% think that this helps, and 10% think that we have to forget about this agenda. Maxim, what's your opinion about this topic? And the second question, the first two questions we asked banks,
интенсивность этого
as we say, real sector.
Возросла, наверное, году 18-м, когда там
how do you deal with digital agenda? How do you use digital technologies?
Там, не знаю, финансовых услуг.
I have a little concern when I look at the timer. It's good that I don't need an interpreter.
С большим отставанием.
I agree with voting. I voted for the option that had the most number of choices. In my company, I'm responsible for digitalization, and we have a session that combines both agendas. For us, as for the production company,
it is clear
that it's important to work with climate as well as digitalization agenda. And we do so. The intensity of both processes increased in 2018. In terms of digitalization, we could compare ourselves with companies from other sectors like financing services, IT, retail. And we could see that chemical industry is really behind on this line of the graph. So we have the goal. And sustainable development appeared when some limitations appeared, and we had to monitor and control the parameters of our product. Regarding the climate change, a general approach is when we try to reduce what we generate, scope 1 or scope 2, we as production company understand this. And this is one thing. We are trying to reduce emissions here. Another part is acquisition of carbon by ecosystem. So each of these two directions has a potential for digitalization. Where we act as a production company, where we use our production processes, we have the topics that we developed from 2018 very intensively, when we equip our systems, automate our controlling systems and technological processes. In Sibur, we have over 90% penetration. And our goal is 100% by 2026, so that we have all our production facilities. We integrate with PPI of Tatarstan Republic, and we merge quite actively, and by 2024 we are going to merge. And initial philosophy was about effectiveness and security, because effectiveness relates to security, and it shows the direct emissions and how much resources we spend, how much energy is spent. For example, we have some digital solutions to anticipate and work with data and foresee some kinds of leaks.
150 тысяч, на самом деле, мое понимание, это очень много, которые раскрывают, да, не финансовые показатели, но...
Or discharge of hydrocarbons to the flare. It influences both the ecology and economy. In this case, they act together, so we have solutions that we implement. And there are very simple things when drones are used to monitor the sites and how water consumption influences the ecology and how the... And how pollutant emissions are injected into the atmosphere, or how drones help
поглощением, понимая то, какие там из высаженных растений и деревьев, да, имеют вот этот наибольший потенциал.
How our subcontractor deals with the waste. So these digital solutions help to have effectiveness and to influence the ecology to reduce the energy capacity.
В возрасте от 5 до 8 лет дерево будет поглощать больше, чем
and
выделять.
We also
то есть вот в этой части как раз мы за то, что
show their data,
здесь тоже Татьяна
said that 150,000 companies is not a lot, but we think it is a lot and we are one of those.
Это наш все-таки бизнес, но мы понимаем, что это важно и понимаем, что мы можем использовать на при масштабировании.
So we show our results, we calculate scope 1 and scope 2 and we can see the data right here. This is the first thing I wanted to mention.
Наверное, последнее, о чем хочу тоже здесь сказать, вот в этой части.
And the second thing is regarding sequestration or absorption.
И все то, что вроде как у нас возобновляемые источники энергии. То есть цифровизация дает, и, кстати, деревьями, да?
We don't do it directly. We are partners.
Выделяем CO2. Вот
overpilot carbon.
С цифровизацией. То есть дата-центры мощнейшие, которые потребляют очень много энергии.
Landfill. And our colleagues try to adjust.
К 2030 году, кажется, по прогнозу
monitoring and control and accounting
в общей структуре выбросов глобально это of capturing. Это очень много.
Which
вот
plants
баланс,
or trees have the most potential? So they calculated the potential. So, for example, one tree absorbs 16 kilos per year of CO2, but emitted twice more.
Спасибо большое. Ну, тоже говорите, вот,
a tree has a period from 5 to 8 years when they capture more CO2 than they emit.
Все, что вы сказали про дата-центры, это безусловно правильно.
So here we stand for
эффективности самих цифровых технологий, в том числе с точки
technology and digitalization, because we understand that it's really important. We can use it while scaling our products as a good potential for sequestration. So one more thing I'd like to mention here.
Как-то подключить, чтобы мы увидели.
We can say it's the same as with electric cars and renewable sources of energy. We capture, but at the same time we emit CO2, and we need a balance. And the same with digitalization. We have data centers that use a lot of energy by 2030, according to forecasts.
Здравствуйте. У нас, как я уже говорила,
data centers would account for a really significant share in all
международный финансовый центр в Казахстане и, собственно, возглавляет в нем ESG-повестку. И у меня к вам просьба рассказать, чем, собственно, с точки зрения ESG, да, какие возможности, может быть, есть в Международном финансовом центре,
или какие
проекты вы привлекаете, какие проекты финансируете. Расскажите про ваш опыт в связи с
total structure, and will account for 8% of the total structure.
Синергии между цифровизацией и климатической повесткой, пожалуйста.
And of course, there is the development of digitalization and the high level of technological processes, but at the same time we need to make sure that they do not use more. Yes, as you say, 20% of negative influence on climate, it's a very serious concern, and what you said about data centers, it is really important. This is about the modernization and creating more effective solutions for data centers to reduce the carbon footprint and general influence on the environment. We have one more speaker today. Can we see him? While we are waiting for the speaker, good afternoon, can you hear us?
Айдар,
good afternoon, this is Айдар Казыбаев, he represents International Financial Center in Kazakhstan, he's a CEO of ACG agenda there. I would like to ask you to tell us what are the opportunities in terms of ESG of your center, what projects do you attract, what projects do you finance, tell about your experience in this field. Tell about the development of synergy between digitalization and ecological agenda. I'm very happy to participate in this conference. Unfortunately, I could not come.
Большой плюс то, что цифровизация в целом
снижает now in Bishkek, and we are preparing to issue the bonds on the Kyrgyz Stock Exchange. There also will be a debut issue of green bonds in December. So we think that green agenda is very important, and we are preparing to develop it. And we think that there are some projects where green agenda has no borders. And today in Kazakhstan there is the day of digitalization. Such a coincidence.
And
UN issued a report today regarding online payments, and Kazakhstan made a significant breakthrough. It takes the 8th place in the world on the quality of online services and payments. So we think that the progress of digitalization in Kazakhstan can be seen. And the input, of the fintech industry is really significant. And the input of NFC deposit, where the fintech industry started, together with the regulatory sandbox, registrations in crypto started.
Снижение активности на рынке.
Binance opened its representative office, and this is this opened great opportunities for businesses to develop technologies. And the question whether this digitalization has a negative impact on ecology. I see positive and negative sides here. A significant positive impact is the digitalization gives us time saving, and we can reduce document, paper document turnover. And of course, we can save on flights. We can do a lot of things online. So there is less pressure on air connection, and people are used to digital communication. We are pioneers in the Central Asia in terms of financial sustainable financing market. So we are pioneers in Central Asia in developing sustainable finance market.
Должны представить свои ESG идеи, которые будут масштабированы для всей республики.
In 2016, the Center of Green Finance was created.
Недавно, неделю назад,
and we've created
инициативу
green
о том, что
taxonomy standards.
Эра, эпоха пятой промышленной революции.
We finished the development of social finances.
Биткоин, криптовалюта, это является
and we have also finished the work on methodology from G rating.
Пятая революция промышленная, наверное, будет больше связана с технологиями по улавливанию, хранению, утилизации CO2. В качестве цифровой валюты место роль будет смещаться в сторону карбоновых единиц. Потому что почему мы такой вывод сделали? В связи с тем, что все страны Парижского соглашения принимают меры, что к 40-му, 50-му году все перейдут на систему Net Zero.
And soon a new G-rating agency is going to appear.
10-15 лет,
in general, the market of green bonds
exists. Что является базой для расчета углеродных
нейтральности.
Это
large state and
соответственно,
like state companies
мы предполагаем, что в будущем не каждый гражданин человек будет считать свой углеродный след и, соответственно, захочет получать какие-то доходы за то, что за счет того, что
and
он снижает
the market
и вкладывает
of sustainable
деньги в
лесные, for
лесные ресурсы по улавливанию, на ВИЭ и прочие проекты. Поэтому мы сейчас считаем, что
so the market of green bonds is not really large. It is due to the fact that state companies and like state companies, large companies do not participate in this. We have more commercial projects, private projects. And the share of green and social sustainable bonds accounts for $300 million. There are around 12 issuers.
Она уместно сочетается в будущее зеленой планеты.
Here we can see the reduction of activity on the market of sustainable bonds due to volatility of national currency rate. And I think soon situation will change. The ideas we are working on right now. Now we are working with the Russian Bank of Development. We are going to develop ESG marketplace. We also start to develop digital start to issue digital bonds
that is based on blockchain technology.
Besides, we are thinking how to issue national bonds related to the project Clean Air, and we have created ESG Club. It's not like in Russia, because it's not a legal entity. It's just more like a unit of banks and organizations who input into the ESG agenda in Kazakhstan. We have projects on ECOR, labeling and packaging. All 40 companies should represent their ESG ideas that will be scaled in the whole republic. So a week ago, I represented an initiative that there is an era of the fifth industrial revolution. And now we observe that cryptocurrency is kind of evolution, and we can call cryptocurrency the fourth industrial revolution, and the fifth industrial revolution will be related to technologies on capturing and storing CO2. And the digital currency, I think the digital currency will be carbon unit. Why we made this conclusion? All countries of Paris Agreement take measures to transfer to net zero system by 2040-2050. So they agree that in 10-15 years, everything will be in digital field, and we should have a unit or like digital currency, which is carbon unit. So we anticipate that in the future everyone will calculate their carbon footprint and to get some income, and maybe to invest into some forest resources to capture carbon footprints. So we started to develop the model to trade carbon units, not like on the trade exchange, but like in digital exchange, because we think that to trade CO2 units, the best platform is blockchain. As there we could see how this CO2 appeared, how it was utilized, and how it was stored. So this system of CO2 trading and agenda correlates with the future green planet. So this is, in a nutshell, what I wanted to say. Айдар, thank you very much. Your idea that the main currency in the world will not be dollar or euro or yuan, but carbon unit, this is a very interesting point of view, very interesting idea. I think we all need to think about it. Dear colleagues, Айдар touched a very interesting topic about trading carbon units on Moscow Stock Exchange. We started to trade carbon units. I don't know whether Sber participated in this. Tatiana, could you tell us more about that? Maybe not all colleagues know about this project, how it operates, and about your experience. Thank you very much. I would say directly, the first experience of trading in carbon units should be estimated. Correctly. This is not practice. This is an experiment that was collected from scratch to check whether this is functional, whether all these parts can be collected together and whether they functionate together. And in the near future, whether they can be as systems. What we saw today, that was just a handmade experiment that was held in a comfortable way very quickly. When we learned about it, we decided that we will take part in it. And you understand that Sberbank is a huge structure, huge body, and we cannot immediately step in into the monetary relationship. But our colleagues prepared everything
то, о чем вы говорите, да,
как very well, so we could register and we could take part in this deal, and 20 units were sold, and we bought a half of them, so the fact of trading took place. I would like to thank our colleagues who took part in this, and the initiators were colleagues from Energy Saving Committee, and the platform was ready for any experiment, so everything went smoothly. The main thing now is just the final resume. Technologically, we are ready to work with this. The main concern is to create the market. We do not have the market yet, so we need to define
там инициатив. Она абсолютно права.
It was clear when the cost of carbon units was defined. It was a certain cost, not market price. So it was, the price was 1,000 rubles per carbon unit, and this is how it happened. Thank you very much. I have a question to Maxim.
Единицы. Там все
Maxim, you told us a lot how you use different
поэтому
indicators.
Здесь, конечно, рынка,
so your company is one of the
рынка,
most professional who provide climatic accounting. Do the technology help to make accounting reports? And will you be ready to continue more based on the international standards, whether will you prepare the reports? And what do you think about trading carbon units?
Использовать какие-то решения
regarding the non-financial,
например, в сегменте ЖКХ, в котором
disclosure,
у нас много
I
что
see how
сделать,
we collect data,
да? И не всегда концессии работают, то, например, эти решения, эти эффекты связаны с
CO2
и закладыванием стоимости, возможно, эти эффекты потом валидировать и оформить как мне кажется, тогда бы это вообще в целом простимулировал бы инвестиции, приход инвестиций в эту
ecological
область.
Indicators
вот,
and climate
вот
indicators.
Логике, конечно,
and we are all used
ну,
to deal with ecological parameters, but we did not deal with climate ones. So automatization really helps to collect data.
Потому что мы все равно делаем инициативы,
non-financial disclosure
с снижением наших выбросов.
Backside of strategic commitments that company has, and that we digitized. This is a set of responsibilities on ecological influence or some responsibilities in social sphere. We have disclosure there, and the formats, when we join together financial and non-financial standards of disclosure, it will be easy to do, and it will be obligatory.
Пополнить даже по 1000 рублей за тонну, это было бы правильно. Ну а с точки зрения спроса, получается,
это
если мы захотим продать, то, соответственно, для нас это отделение экономических
эффективности.
Что нам проще сделать? Осуществить какую-то капитальную инвестицию, мероприятие по снижению, или купить соответствующий объем углеродных
испарений.
Для бизнеса, это придает больше гибкости и вариативности.
There was a conference a few months ago,
and
there was a question, they asked to raise hands who is going to sell carbon units, and everyone showed hands, but when they asked who is going to buy, no one was going to buy, so the market is just the demand and the offer, so the market where there is motivation for both sides, we don't have right now. The motivation to use more energy efficient solutions in utility payments. These effects related to CO2 and to validate these effects and to make carbon units from them, that would definitely stimulate the appearance of investments there. So the creation of the market seems quite right here, quite feasible. We still do initiatives related to the reduction of our emissions, and very quickly we come to the stage where there are feasible and non-feasible initiatives. And when we create the demand for carbon units so that we can make an initiative and monetize it, and if we have this monetary flow, even if we sell 1,000 rubles per unit, it would be really good. And if we want to buy, of course, we will think about the logics, about the interest, whether it is worth buying or invest in something else. So for business, it makes it more flexible and gives more variations how it reduces the total volume. And this is a part of an input into the general agenda. By 2060, we even have password here, 2060. Thank you very much. I have one more question to Алексей Мирошниченко.
мы получили какие
итоги данные. We make climatic stress tests in the central bank.
Насколько они подтверждены?
We have some climate forecast, and then we break it into financial sectors and to understand which financial institutions will influence this forecast. Last year we made the model of decarbonization of Russian economy. Could you please tell us how you did it and did you use any digital tools? Of course, we used digital tools, but not in the sense that we would like to use them. We do not have big data that can be taken from registers, only maybe from Russian statistics. So we had only figures,
и тем самым являются просто экономически выгодными для компании. Да, то есть совмещаем, компания совмещает выгодное с
изъятием. We had only figures that our employees could find just under the agreement with their colleagues from different state bodies. So these were
те объемы, которые сейчас.
On the one hand, these were not really closed data, but at the same time we could not get it in the open sources.
Состоялись более чем укладываясь в эту модель. Поэтому,
несмотря на то, что данные мы брали по старинке, to have data that is more verified and that is gained from more sources. We got only internal data. And whether they are confirmed technically, we are not sure. We could just rely on what we had. So the volume of projects can be done in green financing format, but on the other hand, we can have modern and optimized formats for enterprises, and they do not only reduce carbon emissions, but they also increase the efficiency and let return investments, so they are economically really profitable for the company. So this is how a company combines profit with green. So it obtains investments and makes input into the green economy. So we see that these operations that happened on the market are a part of this model. And the data that was taken from Excel sheets compared to the results we have now seems to be quite precise. So if we have a unified format of reporting for every company, this is what Maxim mentioned, if we could use it as economic data, and if we use data from
climatической повестки, данных не хватает. Мы на самом деле не понимаем до конца, что происходит, сколько там выбросов.
From satellites.
И по экологической повестке, в принципе.
If we use data from satellites.
То же самое.
So
вторая
the
тема, это, конечно, прогнозирование.
Forecast could be really precise. And we also could make good images and pictures.
Как они влияют на ситуацию. Но еще две проблемы.
That was made from satellite in the project that were implemented in green financing. And the effect from green investments could be measured by objective tools. Right now these are reports, paper reports, hand verification, then it is turned into Excel sheets, and then it is further developed into summaries. So we have old school approach. Thank you very much. I would like to summarize.
Да, я так полагаю, что это вопрос в предложении разных продуктов, может быть, и вот таких.
So we discussed the data, and we see that there is not enough data in the climate agenda. We do not understand what's going on. How many emissions we have, and the ecological agenda has the same problem. The second token is forecasting and anticipating using digitalization to understand how the changes that we implement change the situation. And we touched two more problems. Maybe they are specific for our country. The problem, who would buy carbon units? We have a lot of sellers, but we don't have enough buyers and also investors and financial tools. We have a lot of sellers, but we need someone to buy. And I was interested here what Tatiana said, ESG profile for retail. And I think that this is the offer with different products, maybe ecological products. Usually we have questions and I would like to ask Stas from the audience. Yeah, you have the microphone. What do you think? Is it a good idea to build ESG profiles
зеленые облигации, требований, каких-то надбавок.
To attract physical persons. Yes, I just came here today, last year ESG agenda was really popular, but this year it is not that popular, but I think it's really important to think what footprint we leave. It's strange that we were not invited. I would like to participate, so I was thinking, what can we do to minimize the influence, the negative influence of humans? And our colleagues try to enter through finances or corporate business, green bonds and a lot of requirements. However, my opinion is that there are physical persons, and if Sberbank actively participates in that, we would like to discuss this. We have a lot of ESG activities, and one of those was just goodbye the package. If people leave the package, the bag in the shop, plastic package or bag in the shop, we gave them some bonus. And huge retailers have an opportunity to give their clients to show this position and somehow to participate in this, to walk more, to use private cars less, to invest more into education. We need to look into the sources of corporate clients and producers, but it is important to attract physical persons. And there are ecosystems like Sberbank, Yandex, VK. They need to attract physical persons so that the client can show their position. And this will help to reduce emissions. I support your position. You've mentioned some criteria how we analyze the behavior of our retail customers, ESG behavior, and we also form products based on their behavior and the system of bonuses.
На этом мы Let's do it together. В принципе, очень рада, что у нас аудитория.
We have 15 million people. Okay, I see that we have at least one result of our session. Let's finish. I'm very happy that our audience supports the climatic agenda and digital agenda and thinks that together we can reach good results. I would like to thank our panel participants for your participation in the discussion and for your work in this direction. It's really important. Dear colleagues, thank you very much that you stayed till the end. Have a good green evening.